Hello friends, glad to have you back, and believe it or not, we have a Starship update for you today to begin with, as multiple Starbase developments and a Starlink launch were carried out in less than a day. Let's look into it. We're quite well acquainted with the pace of Starship progression at SpaceX's Texas facilities, and very recently Starbase witnessed two major events in the facility. First one is the rollout of Ship 25 from the factory towards the pad, and the restack of Ship 24 atop Booster 7 being the second event. According to reports, on the 19th of October, Wednesday, after sunset, SpaceX teams rolled out the freshly built Ship 25 from the high bay to the Starship launch pad. Later, it was attached to a crane and was kept as it is to wait for daylight to begin the waiting procedure. On the 20th of October at 9 a.m. Central Daylight Time, they lifted Ship 25 atop one of the two Starship test stands. And as per sources, SpaceX engineers will now gradually carry out multiple qualification tests of the new prototype. Sources further state that possibly the Ship 25 qualification tests will begin in the upcoming week, starting with cryoproof tests. The test stand on which Ship 25 now rests is an upgraded one equipped with 6 hydraulic rams. And according to some sources, these rams will help in the simulation of the thrust of 6 Raptor V2 engines, while the prototype is fully loaded with liquid propellant and oxidizer, ultimately blending both mechanical and thermal stresses in a single test. Now, as soon as Ship 25 carries out all the proof tests successfully, it's expected that SpaceX teams will directly send it back to the factory for Raptor engine installation, and then they'll head for static fire test of Ship 25 back in the pad. Once more, we can see so much activity in the Starbase ring yard. Ship 26 nose section making a break from the mid bay into the high bay, nose cone 28 for Ship 27 also out of the low bay and headed over to the high bay. Now, while Ship 25 was being lifted on the test stand, on the same day, SpaceX teams had also restacked the Ship 24 atop B7, ultimately carrying out the 5th full Starship stack in SpaceX's history, as well as assembling the world's most powerful rocket once again. Just like the previous stack, SpaceX used the Mechazilla arms to lift and secure Ship 24 on top of Booster 7. According to some reports, after the 4th Ship 24 and Booster 7 were disassembled due to forecasts of high winds in the Boca Chica area, and this recent 5th full stack indicates SpaceX is going to kick off the fully assembled Starship test campaign as per schedule, that on Monday, the 24th of October. While these were happening in Boca Chica, Florida also witnessed two SpaceX movements there. One is Falcon 9 booster B-1069's arrival in Port Canaveral, then transferring it from the drone ship deck to a stand, and the other one is launch of Starlink 436 mission atop Falcon 9 booster B-1062. On the 20th of October at 10:51 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time, SpaceX teams launched the Starlink 436 mission from SLC 40 pad at Florida's Cape Canaveral Space Force Station. Siva Bharadvaj, SpaceX Space Operations Engineer, stated during the launch webcast that, "With the completion of today's launch, it marks SpaceX's 48th successful Falcon 9 mission of 2022. As per sources, this was SpaceX's 100th flight from the Cape Canaveral Space Force Station, as well as the 10th overall flight of Falcon 9 booster B-1062. After completing the launch, the booster landed on a drone ship, a shortfall of gravitas. After this launch, SpaceX has almost 3,100 estimated operational satellites in orbit. Now, as per Musk's predictions, the Starship test campaign is likely to start with a full wet dress rehearsal of the full-stack Starship, ship and booster. If this WDR test of both the stages becomes successful, then they'll possibly restart the static fire testing of Booster 7 Raptor engines, and will eventually reach the stage of firing all 33 Raptor V2 engines. Depending on the data collected and success of both wet dress rehearsal and static fire test, SpaceX engineers may either allow Booster 7 and Ship 24 for orbital launch, or will retire them and head towards a fresh pair of Ship and Super Heavy Booster. If both Ship 24 and B-7 fail to qualify for orbital flight debut, then possibly Booster 8 and Ship 25 will serve as a replacement. Booster 8's already completed and is waiting on the pad for quite a long time for tests. Ship 25 is already on the test stand, so if their tests are carried out in rapid succession, then they'll easily work as a backup for the present Ship and Booster. Other than this, Booster 9 is also nearing completion, and very soon it will become ready for proof testing. Musk had also stated that Booster 9 will have some remarkable upgrades to make it more resilient to Raptor engine failures during flight. Also, it will feature battery-powered thrust vectoring, so Booster 9 will bring up a lot of changes. With a perfect business mind, SpaceX has brought up an upgraded rideshare program. We'll put an end to our discussion with the next update. The rideshare program from SpaceX has been updated, enabling even more small satellite owners to launch their satellites into orbit for incredibly affordable costs. In August 2019, with its SmallSat program, SpaceX entered the expanding field of SmallSat launch aggregators. At first, the business provided a tiered pricing structure, with various charges for the various sizes of ports a satellite operator could attach their spacecraft to. SpaceX sought to charge a minimum of $2.25 million for up to 150 kilograms, or 330 pounds, and a flat $15,000 for each additional kilogram from clients who ordered their launch services more than a year in advance. A 33% premium, 20,000 kilograms, would be charged for customers placing their orders 6 to 12 months before launch. But given that the business quickly changed to a more straightforward price structure, it's possible that SpaceX seriously miscalculated the market. Prices were halved by 3 times at SpaceX, and a portal was added to make it simple for customers to book launch services online. The majority of the tier system was also removed. The revised cost was drastically competitive compared to the first attempt, $1 million for up to 200 kilograms or 440 pounds, and $5,000 for each additional kilogram, and overnight established SpaceX as the top provider of rideshare launch services. Aggregators buy spots on SpaceX's rideshare missions and then look for a lot of tiny satellites, often far under 50 kilograms apiece, to try to reach their 200 kilogram minimum, ensuring that even the smallest spacecraft may launch for close to the quoted rate of $5,500 per kilogram. Aggregators probably charge clients far more than SpaceX's base pricing since, as is always the case, a subcontractor has its own expenses to cover and profit margins to pursue. If price gouging was an issue, SpaceX's base price cut to $275,000 for up to 50 kilos, 110 pounds, will effectively decrease the aggregator price gap by a factor of 4. In general, more potential satellite operators will be able to afford and easily purchase rideshare launch services. In order to guarantee this, SpaceX also seems willing to reserve and integrate individual containerized CubeSats without the requirement of an aggregator's dispenser. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.